This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The National Union Party was the name used by the Republican Party for the national ticket in the 1864 presidential election, held during the Civil War. State Republican parties, for the most part, did not change their name. The temporary name was used to attract war Democrats and border state unionists who would not vote for the Republican Party. The party nominated incumbent President Abraham Lincoln and Democrat Andrew Johnson, who were elected in a landslide. Contents 1. Establishment 11. Baltimore Convention 2. Changing mood 3. Fremont withdraws 4. Election 5. Post Lincoln 6. See also 7. Notes 8. References. Establishment. The National Union Party was created in 1864 prior to the end of the Civil War. A faction of anti-Lincoln radical Republicans held the belief that Lincoln was incompetent, and therefore could not be re-elected. A number of radical Republicans formed a party called the Radical Democracy Party, and a few hundred delegates convened in Cleveland starting on May 31, 1864, eventually nominating John C. Fremont, who had also been the Republicans' first presidential standard-bearer during the 1856 U.S. presidential election. Baltimore Convention. Republicans loyal to Lincoln created a new name for their party and convention at Baltimore, Maryland during the first week in June 1864, in order to accommodate the war Democrats who supported the war and wished to separate themselves from the Copperheads. This is the main reason why war Democrat Andrew Johnson was selected to be the vice presidential nominee. Then current Vice President Hannibal Hamlin was not nominated. The National Unionists supporting the Lincoln-Johnson ticket also hoped that the new party would stress the national character of the war. The convention's temporary chairman, Robert Jefferson Breckinridge of Kentucky, explained that he could support Lincoln on this new ticket because, as a Union party, I will follow you to the ends of the earth, and to the gates of death. But as an abolition party, as a Republican party, as a Whig party, as a Democratic party, as an American party, I will not follow you one foot. News of his nomination at the 1864 National Union Convention elicited Lincoln's famous response on June 9, 1864, "I am very grateful for the renewed confidence which has been accorded to me, both by the convention and by the National League. I am not insensible at all to the personal compliment there is in this, yet I do not allow myself to believe that any but a small portion of it is to be appropriated as a personal compliment. The convention and the nation, I am assured, are alike animated by a higher view of the interests of the country for the present and the great future, and that part one am entitled to appropriate as a compliment is only that part which I may lay hold of as being the opinion of the convention and of the league, that I am not entirely unworthy to be entrusted with the place I have occupied for the last 3 years. I have not permitted myself, gentlemen, to conclude that I am the best man in the country, but I am reminded, in this connection, of a story of an old Dutch farmer, who remarked to a companion once that it was not best to swap horses when crossing streams. In August 1864, Lincoln wrote and signed a pledge that, if he should lose the election, he would nonetheless defeat the Confederacy by an all-out military effort before turning over the White House. This morning, as for some days past, it seems exceedingly probable that this administration will not be re-elected. Then it will be my duty to so cooperate with the president-elect, as to save the Union between the election and the inauguration, as he will have secured his election on such ground that he cannot possibly save it afterward. Lincoln did not show the pledge to his cabinet, but asked them to sign the sealed envelope. Changing mood. The complexion of the war changed as the election approached. Confederate commander Robert E. Lee's last victory in battle occurred June 3, 1864, at Cold Harbor. Union General Ulysses S. Grant's aggressive tactics trapped Lee in the trenches defending Richmond. Admiral David Farragut successfully shut down Mobile Bay as a Confederate resource in the Battle of Mobile Bay, August 3-23, 1864. Most decisive of all, Union General William Tecumseh Sherman captured Atlanta on September 1, 1864, convincing even the pessimists that the Confederacy was collapsing. Fremont withdraws. Fremont and his fellow Republicans hated their former ally U.S. Postmaster General Montgomery Blair. Fremont, aware that his candidacy could result in victory for the Democrats, made a deal to drop out of the presidential race in exchange for Blair's removal from office on September 22, 1864. Fremont dropped out of the race on September 23. Lincoln asked for, and received, Blair's resignation. The National Union ticket went on to win handily in the election of 1864. defeating the Democratic ticket of General George B. McClellan, whom Lincoln had previously relieved of his command, and George H. Pendleton election. The Republican Party called itself the Union Party in 1864 and gave out this ballot for supporters to vote for Abraham Lincoln in the 1864 congressional elections. The party won 42 Senate seats out of 54 senators seated, not including vacancies due to the secession of Confederate states, and 149 seats out of 193 in the House of Representatives. These candidates ran under various party names, including National Union, Republican and Unconditional Union, but were part of the overall Republican, National Union effort post-Lincoln. Upon Lincoln's death in 1865, Andrew Johnson became the only other National Union president after the bitter break with the Republicans in Congress over Reconstruction policies. Johnson used federal patronage to build up a party of loyalists, but it proved to be unsuccessful. Johnson's friends sponsored the 1866 National Union Convention in August 1866 in Philadelphia as part of his attempt at maintaining a coalition of supporters. The convention sought to bring together moderate and conservative Republicans and defecting Democrats and forge an unbeatable coalition behind President Andrew Johnson and his Reconstruction policy. In the fall of 1866, Johnson embarked upon a speaking tour known as the Swing Around the Circle before the 1866 congressional elections to attempt to garner support for his policies. His swing was heavily ridiculed and proved ineffective as more of his opponents were elected. Republican National Committee Chairman Henry Jarvis Raymond, 1864-1866, lost the regard of the Republicans for his participation in the convention. The National Union movement became little more than the Democratic Party in a new form as Republicans left the movement and returned to the old party fold by the fall. Grant Colfax, 1868. National Union Republican campaign poster. The last congressman to represent the National Union Party ended his affiliation with the party in March 1867. Andrew Johnson was impeached by the Republican-led House of Representatives in 1868, and he was acquitted in the United States Senate by one vote upon the 1869 expiration of Johnson's only term as U.S. President. The National Union Party came to an end. The platform adopted at the 1868 Republican National Convention strongly repudiated President Johnson, while the platform adopted by the 1868 Democratic National Convention thanked Johnson. Johnson received dozens of votes on the first ballot of the Democratic Convention, but the party ultimately nominated Horatio Seymour. Meanwhile, the mainline Republicans decided at their 1868 National Convention to use the term the National Union Republican Convention. The 1868 National Union Republican delegates nominated Ulysses S. Grant for president and his running mate Schuyler Colfax for vice president in 1872. All reference to Union had disappeared. Historians regard the initial National Union coalition assembled in 1864 as part of the Republican Party lineage and heritage. See also History of the United States Republican Party, History of the United States Democratic Party, National Union Convention Notes. Carrot Arthur Schlesinger Jr., Ed. History of U.S. Political Parties, Volume 2, 1860-1910-1973-2-1287. Carrot John G. Nicolay and John Hay, Abraham Lincoln, A History 1899-66. Carrot Mark Grimsley and Brooks D. Simpson, eds. The Collapse of the Confederacy 2001 p. 80. Carrot Lincoln, Memorandum Concerning His Probable Failure of Re-election, August 23, 1864. Collected Works of Abraham Lincoln, Volume 7, p. 514, 1953. Carrot Allen Nevins, War for the Union 4-97-98, 120-22. Carrot Elections, 1864 Overview. Harpweek retrieved August 6, 2011. Johnson, David. Decided on the Battlefield, Grant, Sherman, Lincoln and the Election of 1864. 2012 Nevins, Allen. The War for the Union, The Organized War to Victory, 1864-1865-1971, pp. 97-143. Nicolay, John G. and John Hay, Abraham Lincoln, A History 1890. Volume 9, Chains 3, 15, 16. McSeveny, Samuel T., Re-Electing Lincoln, The Union Party Campaign and the Military Vote in Connecticut, Civil War History 1986 322-139-158. Waugh, John C. Re-Electing Lincoln, The Battle for the 1864 Presidency 2001 Excerpt and Text Search. Zornow, William Frank. Lincoln and the Party Divided 1954 v.e. National Political Parties in the United States. List of political parties in the United States. Major parties. Democratic, Republican. Third parties. Larger 1 Green Libertarian Smaller 2 American 1969 American Freedom American Populist Americas American Solidarity Black Riders Liberation Christian Liberty Citizens Communist Constitution Democratic Socialists Freedom Road, Socialist Freedom Socialist Humane Independent American Justice Legal Marijuana Now Marijuana Modern Whig National Socialist Movement New African Black Panther New Black Panther Objectivist Pacifist Peace and Freedom Pirate Progressive Labor Prohibition Reform Revolutionary Communist Socialism and Liberation Socialist Socialist Action Socialist Alternative Socialist Equality Socialist Workers Unity Veterans Working Families Workers World World Socialist Former Parties America First American Know Nothing American 1924 American Nazi American Vegetarian Anti-Masonic Black Panther Boston Tea Citizens Commonwealth Land Constitution 1952 Constitutional Union Democratic Republican Farmer Labor Federalist Free Soil Gold Democrats Greenback Independence 2007 Labor 1919 Labor 1996 Liberal Republican Liberty National Republican National States Rights National Union 1864 Natural Law New Alliance New Union Nullifier Opposition Populist People's Personal Choice Progressive 1912 Progressive 1924 Progressive 1948 Raza Unida Readjuster Silver Silver Republican Socialist Socialist Labor States Rights Dixiecrat Unconditional Union Union 1936 Unionist 1850s, 60s U.S. Labor Whig Youth International 1 At least 100,000 registered party members nationwide 2 Fewer than 100,000 members state and local political parties without national body presidential nominating conventions Politics of the United States Politics Portal V.E. Abraham Lincoln 16th President of the United States 1861-1865 U.S. Representative from Illinois 1847-1849 Presidency First Inauguration. Perpetual Union Lincoln Bible Second Inauguration Civil War Confiscation Acts President Lincoln's 75,000 volunteers War-based income tax Seaports Blockade RMS Trent Affair Habeas Corpus Suspended Emancipation Proclamation West Virginia Statehood Overland Campaign Strategy Hampton Roads Conference Tour of Richmond Reconstruction 13th Amendment Abolishing Slavery Dakota War of 1862 Department of the Northwest Homestead Act of 1862 National Banking Acts Thanksgiving Day Burkard Letter Bixby Letter National Academy of Sciences Department of Agriculture Pardons State of the Union Address, 1863-1864 Cabinet Judicial Appointments Assassination Funeral and Burial Lincoln Catafalque Speeches Lyceum Address 1838 Peoria Speech 1854 Lost Speech 1856 House Divided Speech 1858 Lincoln-Douglas Debates 1858 Cooper Union Address 1860 Farewell Address 1861 First Inaugural Address 1861 Gettysburg Address 1863 Event Second Inaugural Address 1865 Life and Views Early Life and Career Black Hawk War Matson Trial Spot Resolutions Boat Lifting Patent Heard v. Rock Island Bridge Co. Baltimore Plot Lincoln's Beard Medical and Mental Health Poetry Religious Views Sexuality Slavery Homes and Places Lincoln Birthplace Knob Creek Farm Lincoln Boyhood Memorial Lincoln State Park Lincoln's New Salem Lincoln Home Lincoln Pioneer Village Little Pigeon Creek Community Cottage at the Soldier's Home Lincoln Bedroom Lincoln Sitting Room Ford's Theater Peterson House Lincoln Tomb Elections Republican National Convention, 1856-1860-1864 National Union Party United States Presidential Election, 1860-1864-1860 Campaign Song Legacy Presidential Library and Museum Papers Lincoln, Net Bibliography Lincoln Memorial Sculpture Reflecting Pool Mount Rushmore Lincoln's Birthday Lincoln Nebraska Statue Abraham Lincoln Healy Painting Abraham Lincoln Sculpture, Washington, D.C. Abraham Lincoln, The Man Statue Lincoln Park Abraham Lincoln, The Head of State Statue Lincoln Trail State Memorial Lincoln The Lawyer Statue Kentucky Statue The Peacemakers Painting Lincoln Highway Other Memorials Photographs Cultural depictions Films Postage stamps Lincoln Penny Currency Art Lincoln Prize Abraham Lincoln Association White House Ghost Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln Lincoln Kennedy Coincidences Family Family Tree Mary Todd Lincoln Wife Robert Todd Lincoln Son Edward Baker Lincoln Son William Wallace Lincoln Son Thomas Tad Lincoln, son Mary Todd Mamie Lincoln, granddaughter Abraham Lincoln, II grandson Jesse Lincoln, granddaughter Thomas Lincoln, father Nancy Hanks Lincoln, mother Sarah Bush Lincoln, stepmother Sarah Lincoln Grigsby, sister Abraham Lincoln, paternal grandfather Mordecai Lincoln, paternal uncle Mary Lincoln Croom, paternal aunt John Hanks, maternal cousin Joseph Hanks, great grandfather Samuel Lincoln, 17th century ancestor Mary Lincoln Beckwith, great granddaughter Robert Todd Lincoln Beckwith, great grandson Timothy Lincoln Beckwith, great great-grandson James Buchanan. Andrew Johnson Book Category.